Is that?
Frank the Cook was here.
Who's that?
Oh, so yeah. Oh, yeah, I guess everybody left. Yeah. The big G was here. Your dad was here.
Garcia, this Danny Garcia thing. No truth to that?
Nah, I keep telling everybody. That's just a rumor. We'll see if that happens. We'll see if it happens soon, but we haven't discussed anything yet.
The Rubens family.
Take a picture of my son.
What's baby, is that your baby?
My son, that's my baby.
A little one.
Ready? Hi, Jason.
You guys all look alike in the family.
Thank you.
He looks like you. Is that your baby?
That's my baby.
Looks like him.
Bye.
Bye, man. Hey, Mikey, how was his part of this?
Oh, that was cool. That was fun. That was fun. You know, he
still have some moves.
Yeah, he came with a good uppercut.
Really?
Yeah. And he kept calling him. He's like, "Come on, Mikey, let's go. Come on, let's go."
Mikey, give me a quick video. My dog.
Reporting.
Reporting.
What's up, Jeff?
What's up, baby? How you doing, man?
Very good. Fine.
What's up?
What? Who's next, Richard?
I'm next.
Hey.
Did Morales still have some pop, Mikey?
Did
Morales still have some pop?
I'll be back in a second.
Dude, he did.
I'll be right back.
I thought he got me with a good uppercut. And I thought he was going to play around before he was serious. Nah, it was fun. It was a fun experience. Very good experience.
Ray.
Hey, gonna go.
Man, you got heart.
No, ni pedo, man. I got on it.
Muy pronto, el primer round. Te lastimó poquito en el primer round.
Sí, me sorprendió con los putazos. Me sorprendió y...
Lo que les digo, que fue el primer round que te agarró casi pues como madurando.
Frío, sí, me agarró frío. Se me agarró bien, pues, pero la madre sí me sorprendió. Yo sentí que con el cuarto ya lo miraba que estaba bajando.
Empezó a sacar unos golpes, los patos en una ocasión.
Sí, man, sentía yo que con los rounds poco a poco se iba a ir mermando. Y por hoy iba para adelante, psicológicamente, también lo quebrando, pues nada más que me agarró con el vergazo y el referee. A mí, la neta, yo sentí que la paró de volada. Dije, oye, yo estoy bien, yo pienso que... Pero como fue la primera vez, se lo mando para protegerme. Pero honestamente, pues yo sentí que la paró muy de volada. Le dije, hey, digo, pues...
No, ya.
Ya, dije, pues ya estamos bien.
Pero sí se la...
You know, it's crazy, Ray. It looks like you haven't been in a fight yet. You look clean.
Yeah.
This is a great fight. It was a war. Glad you're doing okay.
Yeah, man, look good, man. Thank you.
We'll be right back.
I heard they're recording.
Yeah, they're recording over there too. Yeah, what do you think about that?
Yeah, that's a good fight. I don't know.
Frank!
The fuck I heard Frank?
Orale, what's up, Frank? Gaile!
After party.
Amigo!
You can come in.
Hey, Frank! Venga, pues!
Amigo!
Mire, no traen teléfono.
I got to get back in the ring last weekend.
Oh, that was just a fun experience with a little exhibition with Eric Morales. It's a fundraiser. Some people were actually thinking it was going to be a real fight or something. It's not. It was a fundraiser, a little sparring session. It was a friendly sparring session to raise funds for our boy Isaac. So that's all it was. But it was fun to be able to do that with him. You know, so I gave a lot of thanks to Eric for actually being able to come down and volunteer this time for a great cause. And so we were happy to do it, and it turned out great. We had a great turnout. Some good moments there. Some good laughs. You know, that's all it is. And like I said, it's for a great cause.
I asked Elspence the same question. Have you seen an increase in your profile since the Spence fight? And what has that been like?
I mean, I haven't noticed much different. I mean, I've always been the same. You know,
47,000 people were there.
We had a great turnout. You know, we had a great turnout there, and I'm sure we're going to continue to have a great fight, great turnout. We're excited to have that fight. It was a great experience. You know, now that we're looking for the next fight, that's all it is. You know, we've got to keep moving forward.
Mikey, you seem to kind of still have the weight. You have some good weight on you still.
Well, I did go to the snack again. What's that, valet?
Valet?
Yeah.
Behind
right
us.
Right here, no?
Yeah.
Hey, go get the ticket. I went up to snack just we were there for four and a half weeks, five weeks to continue and then get that work in. And I still have the, you know, I wanted to build some muscle just to keep that weight there in case I decided to fight at 47. You know, if the right-off fight was available, you know, that I didn't have problems again feeling sluggish and slow. So I want to make sure I can keep the speed. Just couldn't do it on fight night. Everything else was doing well. I was doing fine every other night except for fight. It just wasn't me. That's it.
You don't feel that welterweight was maybe just a little too big that these guys are...
I think what happened... See, it's not the size, really, of the opponent. It was just me, the size in me on fight night. I mean, I had never stepped inside the ring at, you know, 152, 154. You know, I was always weighing in around 45 for fight nights. This time I'm at, you know, 54 on fight night. I think those 10 pounds actually, you know, did affect me. So that's why I want to make sure that I can perform at that weight. And that's why we've kept, you know, the workouts. We've kept, you know, working on the body, on the size. We've been getting some work in, some sparring, just to stay in shape. We still don't know. Like I said, I don't know where I'm going to fight, 40, 47. I'm available to fight anybody at, you know, 40, 47. So we'll make that decision later, and, you know, we'll see what happens. But you know, we're just staying in shape.
Is 135 for sure in the rear view now? Or?
Well, if I do 140 first and then make my way down to 35, That's a possibility, but I just won't be able to do that on my first one. And the reason why we vacated the title, like I've mentioned before, I was supposed to fight the mandatory, and I just wasn't interested in defending that mandatory, especially not after fighting at 47, coming all the way down to 35, which is not an option for me. So we needed to vacate the title. There's no reason, you know, to hold on to a title, pretend like I'm gonna be there if I'm not. You know, they had already granted me permission to fight at 47. And now they needed, you know, to defend the title at 35, and I just wasn't available.
Is it safe to say that I feel like if it's not a named fighter, Mikey Garcia's name is not going to be next to him?
Well, I mean, it could be. You know, we could fight other guys, and I'm pretty sure I could do it if I wanted to. But if it's not attractive enough for me, then it's not that. You know, I want to make sure that the fans get their money's worth and get fights that they are asking for. And if I fight, you know, top contender, but that's still fairly unknown, the fans don't like that. The fans will start clamoring and calling for other names, and I just don't feel right doing that. I think I've shown the fans that I'm willing to fight anybody, and I want to fight champions, and I want to fight the best, and that's what I'm looking for, you know. So it's not always easy to get a hold of certain names that the fans would want to see, but I work on getting those fights. I'm trying to get some fights for the fans, and you know, if there's a good opponent, you know, a good contender that starts developing and doing well, then we definitely consider him as well.
I feel like the fans would give you a pass, man, on the next one, if you know what I mean.
I mean, it could happen. You know, every once in a while, you know, the great champions take, you know, tune-up fights, but I don't feel like doing that.
140.
I mean, it could happen. I mean, you never know. If all the champions are taken already, then what am I supposed to do? You know, so I'll fight somebody else. No, but I still want to have a top contender. I don't want to just fight, you know, guys rated too low. I want to fight top guys.
140 is on the path for an undisputed champion. Yeah. Would that entice you if there was just one champion left at 140 between Hooker, Ramirez, Prograis, and Taylor?
Look, of course, that would be a great opportunity to collect all the belts at one or two fights. But, you know, they already got their fights lined up. So, like I said, all those champions are already, you know, lined up to fight each other. So there's no title fight available for me right now. So if I decided to fight at 40, it would have to be against another contender because the title fights are not available yet. But if that fight was against one of the champions or against the winner of the tournament and that was presented, then I would definitely look into that more because I would have an opportunity to win, you know, championship fights, you know, multiple titles at once and claim, you know, supremacy. And that's what every fighter would like to do. And I mean, I look forward to something like that, which I don't know if it will happen right
is
now.
There anything you can share on the rumors as far as you facing Danny Garcia? I know nothing is official.
I mean, if you keep up with media, you know, everybody spread out like it was already a done deal, and it really wasn't. In fact, I actually texted the reporter who broke news, and I texted him exactly what agreement did I do, because I don't even know what you're talking about. What terms did I agree on? I don't even know. Maybe you know something I don't know. And that's exactly the truth. I have no terms, no agreement, no nothing. A few months back, it was brought up to my attention if I would be interested
in a potential fight with Danny. Is that something that would interest me?
Sure,
it interests me just like it interests me right now. But that was it. There was never any discussion along dates or venues or network or anything like that. So I don't know where all the other rumors come from, but it happens sometimes in boxing, the media, it's all right. We'll look forward to working on something like that if it's available.
Do you feel like going forward it's necessary for you to fight on pay-per-view now that you kind of got introduced to that and we've seen you on pay-per-view?
It's not necessary, but if the right opponent is in front of me, I think it makes sense. Because also, my opponents also are expecting a bigger payday just because they feel that, oh well, if Mikey just did a pay-per-view and he did so well, we should be, you know, getting paid so much. The network can only pay X amount guarantee. If anything after that budget, then you are forced to do pay-per-view. So it might lead to a pay-per-view for the right opponent. If it's not the right opponent and he's not trying to get, you know, overpaid, then we don't have to do pay-per-view. I mean, it's not something that's a necessary thing. But with the right opponents, I think pay-per-view makes sense because everybody, yeah, is at that level now. You know, if my opponent's at that level, then we could definitely probably push for pay-per-view if it makes better sense.
Last one for me, real quick. Is Eddie Hearn still trying to sign you? Is Eddie Hearn still trying to sign you?
He's always reaching out once in a while. We've had a few conversations. He's never proposed an official offer like that. He's thrown out some figures regarding potential fights just to compare and see if I'm able to go in that direction. I mean, all I did is I tell him, look, if I'm still saying no, if I'm not taking your deal, then you know what I'm doing. Without me telling you the numbers that I'm making, I'll tell you, you know, in a different way. I got something good going on over here. So that's all it is. But I mean, he's a cool guy. The times that I've met with him and talked to him, very straightforward, down to business, you know, tells me exactly what he feels is good and what I should be able to do. But there's never been that official offer for multiple fighters or anything like that. Just conversations.
Jose Ramirez, he wins all the belts at 140. Would you fight him or no?
I think I'm asking him to vacate some belts for me.
Lend them over.
We wouldn't.